Okay, another thing that they could actually do is, because I just realized what team comp they have here is they could have Zed go top, they could have Teemo go... Actually, no. I think the better option is to have Teemo top, that way he can shroom Baron, and have Zed go bottom lane. Because at this point in the game, nobody can 1v1 the Zed. And a lot of Zeds will do this is because in a teamfight situation, there's so many things that can go wrong for Zed. He can get exhausted, he could get hit by CC the moment he ults in, and so it's almost always better for a Zed to split push. And so when you recognize the strengths and weaknesses of your team, you can make better decisions that way. And I can do this because I have lots of experience. I've played, you know, thousands upon thousands of games, and you start to recognize these things on the fly, and like, the higher you go, the more experienced players are, and so they recognize these things as well. And so, you know, other people would say, hey, Zed, go split push. Hey, Teemo, go split push. We'll do 1-3-1. That's typically what people will call it. They'll call it 1-3-1. And it involves one person on each solo wave, or on each side wave, and then have three people in mid. The three people just act as points of pressure. And what this causes is it causes 3 points of pressure, and people have to react to it. It's especially efficient if you're way ahead. So because this Zed is way ahead, if anyone was to stop him, he'd be able to solo them. So it would actually require two people to stop Zed. And this creates an imbalance. And so let's say, for example, there's two people here versus three people here. They could perhaps dive them, they could bully them off this tower, you know, etc, etc. It's even worse is because Teemo's really ahead too, and there's no tier 2 here. And so any poke damage that he gets on the inhibitor turret is really big. It's almost impossible to stop a Teemo, and so they're forced to basically be suffocated out of resources. Another thing that blue team could do as well is, you know, on top of doing 1-3-1, they could counter jungle. They could starve them of resources constantly. Alright, let's see what they do though. But yeah, this is like the main thing that a lot of people have struggles with. They have struggles with the mid-game transition. He's dead. Zed died. The blind! Oh! Alright, here it comes. Alright, cool. Nami recalled or some shit, who knows. Oh, the Teemo Q! Is he maxing his Q? Oh, he's maxing his Q. I was like, that's a lot of damage. But you know, what it really comes down to is League of Legends is a game of resources. It's a game about gold, it's a game about minion and wave manipulation, and it's a game of objectives. you don't have to team fight. You know, you don't even need fucking kills in the game. I'm pretty sure there was like a competitive game where like there was there like a no death like win before? I'm pretty sure there was, or something similar where there's only like really few deaths, like 5 deaths. What it really comes down to is the reason why you team fight, the reason why you kill people is one, for gold, and two, to be able to take down these towers, these inhibitors, you know? It's a game of objectives. Alright, they're still ARAMing, or they're still doing some weird shit. Unlucky. Wait, what the fuck is she doing? Wait, she could have healed him. What? So much info. I mean, when I'm playing a game, I'm constantly thinking about all of these things, you know? Which is why, like, I have to, like, learn to fucking talk fast. Because there's, like, when I'm trying to, like, do commentary, there's, like, a billion things going on in my head. Wait, what the fuck? Wait, what? Who just flashed? Hello? Huh? What did she flash there? Wait, let's watch that again. What was that? Whoa! What the fuck? What? That wasn't even close! Alright.